Om Namah Shivaya. Hi friends, how are you? In this video we are going to learn about the biosynthesis of heme. Biosynthesis of the heme. Heme is the most important porphyrin containing compound. It is primarily synthesized in liver and the erythrocyte producing cells of bone marrow, that is erythroid cells. Heme synthesis also occurs to some extent in other tissues also. However, mature erythrocytes lacking the mitochondria are a notable exception. Biosynthesis of heme occurs in the following steps. See once again biosynthesis of heme. Heme is the most important porphyrin containing compound. It is primarily synthesized in the liver and the erythrocyte producing cells of bone marrow. These are erythroid cells. Heme synthesis also occurs to some extent in other tissues. However, mature erythrocytes lacking the mitochondria are a notable exception. Biosynthesis of heme occurs in the following stages. First formation of delta aminolevulinate. First reaction is, our first stage is formation of delta aminolevulinate. What occurs in this? Glycine is a non-essential amino acid, succinyl coenzyme, and succinyl coenzyme is a intermediate in the citric acid cycle. That means glycine and succinyl coenzyme are the starting materials for porphyrin synthesis. Glycine and succinyl coenzyme are the starting materials for porphyrin synthesis. See what happens. Glycine combines with succinyl coenzyme to form delta aminolevulinate. We call the delta aminolevulinate as ALA, aminolevulinate. This reaction is catalyzed by a pyridoxal phosphate dependent delta aminolevulinate synthase occurs in the mitochondria. It is a rate controlling step in porphyrin synthesis. See once again the formation of delta aminolevulinate. Formation of delta aminolevulinate. Glycine, a non-essential amino acid, and succinyl coenzyme. This is a intermediate in the citric acid cycle. That means this glycine and succinyl coenzyme are the starting materials for porphyrin synthesis. Glycine combines with succinyl CoA to form delta aminolevulinate. This reaction is catalyzed by a pyridoxal phosphate dependent delta aminolevulinate synthase occurs in the mitochondria. This is a rate controlling step in porphyrin synthesis. See this reaction. In the formation of porphyrin synthesis, glycine and succinyl coenzyme are the first raw materials for the formation of delta aminolevulinate. And the first succinyl coenzyme and glycine combines to form the alpha amino beta keto adipate. This is the first formed product, first formed form. And in this reaction, pyridoxal phosphate acts as the catalyst and dependent delta aminolevulinate synthase. And the enzyme here is delta aminolevulinate synthase, and this reaction is catalyzed by pyridoxal phosphate. First succinyl coenzyme and glycine combine to form the alpha amino beta keto adipate. In this reaction, enzyme is delta aminolevulinate synthase, and this reaction is dependent on pyridoxal phosphate. Again, this alpha amino beta keto adipate is This reaction is again dependent on delta amino levulinate synthase. Okay, again the same enzyme to form the delta amino levulinate. Okay, we need this product. This is the first stage. Okay, alpha amino beta keto adipane converted to delta amino levulinate, and the enzyme acts here is delta amino levulinate synthase. Next, synthesis of porphobilinogen. Two molecules of delta amino levulinate condense to form porphobilinogen in the cytosol. This reaction is catalyzed by a zinc containing enzyme delta amino levulinate dehydratase. Okay, this reaction is catalyzed by a zinc containing enzyme delta amino levulinate dehydratase. It is sensitive to inhibition by heavy metals such as lead. See once again, synthesis of porphobilinogen. Two molecules of delta amino levulinate condense to form porphobilinogen in the cytosol. This reaction is catalyzed by a zinc containing enzyme delta amino levulinate dehydratase. It is sensitive to inhibition by heavy metals such as lead. In second step, two molecules of delta amino levulinate condense to form the porphobilinogen. Okay, two molecules of delta amino levulinate condense to form the porphobilinogen and releases the H2O. Okay, and the enzyme acts here is delta amino levulinate dehydratase. Two molecules of delta amino levulinate condense to form porphobilinogen and releases the two molecules of water, and the enzyme acts here is delta amino levulinate dehydratase. Okay, formation of porphyrin ring. This is the third step, formation of porphyrin ring. Porphyrin synthesis occurs by condensation of four molecules of porphobilinogen. Porphyrin synthesis occurs by condensation of four molecules of porphobilinogen. The four pyrrole rings in porphyrin are interconnected by methylene bridges derived from the alpha carbon of glycine. See once again, formation of porphyrin ring. Porphyrin synthesis occurs by condensation of four molecules of the porphobilinogen. The four pyrrole rings in porphyrin are interconnected by methylene bridges derived from the alpha carbon of glycine. The interaction of two enzymes, namely uroporphinogen 1 synthase and uroporphinogen 2 co-synthase. Uroporphinogen 3 co-synthase, okay, results in condensation of porphobilinogen followed by ring closure and isomerization to produce the uroporphinogen 3. See once again the third step, that is formation of porphyrin ring. And porphyrin synthesis occurs by condensation of 4 molecules of porphobilinogen. The 4 pyrrole rings in porphyrin are interconnected by methylene bridges derived from the alpha carbon of glycine. The interaction of two enzymes, namely uroporphinogen 1 synthase and uroporphinogen 3 co-synthase, results in condensation of porphobilinogen followed by ring closure and isomerization to produce uroporphinogen 3. In this reaction, four molecules of porphobilinogen molecules are condensed and releases the four molecules of ammonia to form the Europilinogen 3. See here, and the four molecules of porphobilinogen condensed and becomes the closest structure for the formation of pyrrol rings, okay, to form the europorphyrinogen. And the enzymes act here are europorphyrinogen 1 synthase and europorphyrinogen 3 co-synthase, okay. These are the two enzymes acting in this reaction, okay, for the formation of 4 porphobilinogen molecules to europorphyrinogen 3, okay. The enzymes act in this reaction are europorphyrinogen 1 synthase and europorphyrinogen 3 co-synthase. These are the enzymes acted in this reaction. Conversion of europorphyrinogen 3 to protoporphyrin 9. This is catalyzed by a series of reactions. Europorphyrinogen decarboxylates all the 4 acetate, that is A, and 4 side chains to form the methyl groups, that is M, to produce coproporphyrinogen. Coproporphyrinogen oxidase converts 2 of the propionate side chains, that is P, to vinyl groups, that is V, and results in the formation of protoporphyrinogen. Next, protoporphyrinogen oxidizes methylene groups, interconnecting the pyrrol rings to methanyl groups. This leads to the synthesis of protoporphyrinogen 9. See once again, conversion of europorphyrinogen 3 to protoporphyrin 9. This is catalyzed by a series of reactions. First, in A, europorphyrinogen decarboxylates. Europorphyrinogen decarboxylase, this is the enzyme, and this enzyme decarboxylates all the 4 acetate side chains to form the methyl groups to produce the coproporphyrinogen. That means first from europorphyrinogen 3 to coproporphyrinogen is produced, okay. Next, from coproporphyrinogen oxidase, this is the enzyme, and this converts the coproporphyrinogen to protoporphyrinogen, okay, by propionate side chains to vinyl groups, and results in the formation of protoporphyrinogen. That means europorphyrinogen 3 to coproporphyrinogen. Next, from coproporphyrinogen to protoporphyrinogen. Next, from this protoporphyrinogen oxidase, this is the enzyme, and this enzyme oxidizes methylene groups, interconnecting pyrrol rings to methanyl groups. This leads to the formation of or synthesis of protoporphyrin 9. For the formation of europorphyrin 3 to protoporphyrin 9, this is a chain reaction. First, in this reaction, europorphyrinogen is converted to the coproporphyrinogen, okay, and this coproporphyrinogen to protoporphyrinogen is formed. And next, from this protoporphyrin 9 is formed, okay, thus it's formed. See here, first europorphyrin 3, okay, europorphyrin 3 is converted to coproporphyrinogen. Europorphyrinogen 3 is converted to coproporphyrinogen 3, and in this reaction the enzyme here is europorphyrinogen decarboxylase, okay, and from coproporphyrinogen 3 is converted to protoporphyrinogen 9, okay, protoporphyrinogen In this reaction, enzyme is coprophenogen oxidase. Here oxidase. Next, from protoporphyrinogen 9 is converted to protoporphyrin 9. Protoporphyrin 9. In this reaction, enzyme here is protoporphyrinogen oxidase. Okay. This is the third step from conversion of uroporphyrinogen 3 to protoporphyrin 9. See once again, uroporphyrinogen 3 to coprophenogen 3, and from coprophenogen 3 to protoporphyrinogen 9, and then here to protoporphyrin 9. No gen is here, only porphyrin. Oxygen is deleted here. See, only protoporphyrin. This is the difference. First, 3. 3 is converted to again 3. And from here, in this 3 is converted to 9. See, 9. Again, this 9 is same here, 9, protoporphyrinogen 9, protoporphyrin 9. Okay, next. This is the last step in the biosynthesis of heme. Synthesis of heme from protoporphyrin 9, the incorporation of ferrous iron, that Fe2+ into porphyrin 9, is catalyzed by the enzyme ferrochelatase or heme synthase. This enzyme can be inhibited by len. It is found that the induction of Fe+2 into porphyrin 9 can occur spontaneously, but at a slow rate. See once again, synthesis of heme from protoporphyrin 9, the incorporation of ferrous iron into protoporphyrin 9 is catalyzed by the enzyme ferrochelatase or heme synthase. This enzyme can be inhibited by len. It is found that the induction of Fe+2 into protoporphyrin 9 can occur spontaneously, but at a slow rate. This is the final step in the biosynthesis of heme, and from protoporphyrin 9 is converted to heme. Okay. Protoporphyrin is converted to heme. In this reaction, Fe+2 is incorporated into the protoporphyrin 9. Fe+2 is incorporated into protoporphyrin 9 to form the heme. Okay, to form the heme, and this reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme ferrochelatase. And this reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme ferrochelatase. Okay, succinyl coenzyme A and glycine combine to form the alpha amino beta keto adipine, and the enzyme here is delta amino levulinate synthase. Okay, again this alpha amino beta keto adipate is converted to delta amino levulinate. Enzyme here again is delta amino levulinate synthase. Next, two molecules of delta amino levulinate is condensed to form the porphobilinogen. Okay, porphobilinogen. Enzyme here is delta amino levulinate dehydratase. The here H2O is released. And the next, from here, four molecules of porphobilinogen combines to form the porphyrin, and the enzymes acted here are uroporphyrinogen 1 synthase and uroporphyrinogen 3 co-synthase. This is a condensation reaction. In this reaction, 4 molecules of ammonia are released. Next, sorry guys, former product is uroporphyrinogen 3. Okay, next, this uroporphyrinogen 3 is converted to the coprophenogen 3. and the enzyme acted here is decarboxylase. Uroporphyrinogen decarboxylase. And next, coproporphyrinogen 3 is converted to protoporphyrinogen 9. And the enzyme acted here is coproporphyrinogen oxidase. And protoporphyrinogen 9 is protoporphyrin 9. And the enzyme acted here is protoporphyrinogen oxidase. Protoporphyrinogen oxidase. Next, protoporphyrin 9 is converted to the heme. This is the final step in biosynthesis of heme. In this reaction, Fe+2 is incorporated into the protoporphyrin 9, and the enzyme acted here is ferrochelatase. This is the enzyme. This is about the biosynthesis of heme. If you like this video lecture and subscribe, thank you.